Hi, welcome. This is Qtile, and we have something more to explain to you about Quantum. If we go to the Qtile folder, then we have explained already this. We were talking about that, and the next one is Quantum Toggle. And Quantum Toggle is a little script that we've devised a few, months ago on other tiling window managers, because sometimes we want to get rid of the Compton altogether. So the fading, the shading, and the fading is gone then. What it says here is, okay, if Compton is there, yes, then kill Compton. And when it's not there, else you start running Compton. So basically it's a Compton toggle, that's what we called it. So if it's on, put it off. If it's off, put it on, basically. Now, where do we start this thing? Well, we start this in our config py, where everything really starts. So Control F, and we go for Compton, and we'll see that we have here this line, super F. It's going to maximalize everything a little bit so we can read. And a Control Alt O, Control Alt O is going to go to your home directory, which is figured out on top. It's a variable, which is home Eric in my case, and then .config Qtile scripts content toggle sh. So it's, you can add any of your scripts yourself if you have some of those scripts that you like to use. Well, here you have it. You can make a keyboard shortcut and this thing will run. So in this case, it's going to run our little script that says, if content is there, kill it. If content's not there, start it. So that's that. So it's going to be started here. Now let's try it out. And if we take a look at this wallpaper here, we see that there is a conkey, and the conkey is only there just to help you guys with this here. So all the keyboard shortcuts. And so we're trying out Ctrl-Alt-O. And what's going to happen is that the conkey is all black. Conkey, the Compton has been killed. Conkey is no longer transparent. Ctrl-Alt-O again. And this happens. Now let's make it more difficult. Ctrl-Alt-T is our URXVT. And Ctrl-Super-Shift-D, let's launch Termite. So we have two terminals. This is the URXVT, is the standard one on Qtile, and Termite is the standard one on the non-tiling window managers, basically, more or less. The thing is, if we press Ctrl-Alt-O, this happens. And then you say, Eric, it's broken. Well, Termite is all black, but URXVT stays transparent. And that's a little bit special. And I thought, why not include this knowledge again in another video, because it has, of course, already been explained in other videos. Because URXVT is not governed, well, it is governed by Compton, but not really, basically. As you see, nothing changes. A little bit lighter in the border here, but that's it. Now, where is this transparency coming from? It is coming from X resources. So double click your X resources, and I'm already on the correct lines here. URXVT transparent 56. That's what's making your URXVT transparent no matter what. It will stay transparent. Let's take a look at Compton as well. I don't think URXVT, there is something in here. So you could define something in here as well. I was just thinking, is it or not? Because we have changed our Compton so often these days because of the development. So it's not in here. Don't see it anywhere. So X resource is the one defining here the shading and the transparency. So these two guys need to be set. So if you say, okay, I'm gonna get rid of the transparency of URXVT, you just put here in here the correct thing here, and the correct thing is that thing, like so. And If you save it, reboot it, you'll see that your XVT has lost its transparency. If you do a Ctrl-Alt-O, you'll see that also your XVT will stay all black. So that's why your XVT is transparent, and we kind of like it to keep it that way. So I'm not going to save it without saving. So just so you know, if you're toggling and you see why is Super T your XVT, why is it not changing at all? That's why, because it's not defined by Compton, it's defined by X resources. Last time, and there we go. Okay, enjoy.